His second half was just a different story. He was a no-show, a non-factor almost. And again, LeBron did what he could, but I mean, again, LeBron's 38. He can only do so much. And Nikola Jokic, again, he just played lights out. He played like the MVP caliber player that he is, the NBA champion caliber player that he is. That's how he played in last night's game. And his stat line, of course, he had a triple-double, and he had 29 points, 11 assists, and 13 rebounds. Aaron Gordon had a solid game, 15, 7 rebounds, and 5 assists. Jamal Murray, he had a solid game. I'll take that back. Solid, 21, 6, and 2. Kadarius Polk had a real, really good game. He had 20. He was just hitting shots all over the perimeter, especially in the mid-range area. Michael Porter, 12 and 12. 12 points, 12 rebounds. That's good for Michael Porter. Get 12 rebounds from your power forward or small forward position. I think he plays power forward and small forward. But, yeah, anytime you get 12 rebounds from either the small forward or power forward position, that's always good. And, everybody, you know, Reggie Jackson had a decent game, 8 points, 3 rebounds. Kristen Bond, 5 and 3. So, and again for the Lakers, LeBron had 21, 5, and 8. Terry Prince had 18 and 3, 1 assist. He had 1 assist and 3 rebounds and 18 points. D'Angelo Russell, 11 points, 7 assists and 4 rebounds. Austin Reeves had a decent game, 14, 4 assists and 8 rebounds. 14 points, that is, and 4 assists and 8 rebounds. Gabe Vincent, he had 6, but for a reason, I don't even know why he didn't get more minutes. I don't know, maybe they're trying to work him into the rotation, you know, seeing what they got with Gabe Vincent, if that makes sense, see what role he can play off the bench, if that makes sense. But I don't know, I just felt he should have got more minutes this game, because we already know what Gabe Vincent did in this year's playoffs as well. He was a huge contributing factor as to why Miami played in this year's finals against the Denver Nuggets. So the performance he put on in this year's playoffs and the difficulty of shots he made in this year's playoffs was simply great. It was just simply great. He just played lights out basketball as far as it making difficult shots at critical moments of these playoff games. So, again, I think he should have got more minutes, but again, it is the first game of the season, so you really can't, you know, you can't really just go off one game and say what a team is going to what a team is going to look like the rest of the season. But, I mean, again, I hope this is not a trend for Anthony Davis. I hope, you know, all the talk we've been hearing this past offseason is that he's more focused. He's going to be more motivated. He's going to be more of a leader of the team and be more of a reason why the Lakers are going to have a shot at winning an NBA championship this year, if that makes sense. Well, winning an NBA championship next year, if that makes sense. But, again, it's the first game of the season. You really can't go off the first game of the season and predict what a team is going to do going forward. So, we'll see what happens. But Denver's off to a good start. They weather the storm as far as in their celebration of the championship they won this past summer. The banner being lowered and them receiving their rings, they weathered the storm of that and they were able to be victorious, you know, when it was all said and done. And again, the Denver Nuggets defeated the Lakers 119 to 107. Nikola Jokic had a triple double, 29 points, 11 rebounds, and 13 assists. That's all I can report. Y'all take care and stay blessed out there. You and your families. Facts from the Ghost of Podcast, DJ Lottie Dottie. The likes I appreciate, the views I appreciate more. One love. Later.